Hey everyone, it's Ben with SideFX, and today I am talking to the Houdini Game Jam first place winners, David and Kati. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
We're a couple, and that's something important, I would say. We both started game development about 10 years ago separately. She's mostly an artist, and I'm mostly a programmer. We also made our own company for Made Games. We've been together for about 3 years now. We found out that we work very well together as a team. This whole year, I've been learning how to use Houdini for games. I've been using it for a few things on another project. So when we heard about the game jam from Houdini, we thought it will be a very good opportunity to put our skills or what I have learned during this year to the test.
So can you give us a little description of your Houdini Game Jam game, Totally Unexpected Safety Drill?
Our game is about a cartoonish simulation of a fire drill, where you have to calm down some characters we call the dummies, and you have to calm them down and guide them to safety out of a burning building. It has some strategic and puzzle elements. We also wanted it to be fun and kind of easy to understand and simple to play.
Kind of ridiculous also.
Yes, yeah. As you can say for the name, we had a lot of fun coming up with ideas, and we wanted it to be funny and absurd. We didn't want it something
So stressful
or grotesque.
How did you end up using Houdini to make the game?
Our idea was, okay, how will the end user, talking about someone using Unity, will interact with the tool in Houdini, right? So we wanted the level design process to be as easy as possible. What's easier than just placing cubes inside the game engine and hitting a button and converting those cubes into something into the level? We have two kinds of primitives. We have one is just a regular cube that is that represents the floor, the main floor, and other that represents holes and the exit. So inside Houdini, we take those inputs and we extract the silhouette. We create some rooms outside
the main floor.
We came up with different kind of buildings we would like to be able to make. And we also used Houdini for some effects. For example, the fire is made from 3D meshes and the smoke. One very important aspect of the game is this fire mechanic that propagates and grows from room to room and inside the building. In order to accomplish that, I need the building to have some specific set of UVs and some information placed on the mesh. So Houdini was awesome to be able to do that, to have vertex color information, to have specific UVs.
Can you talk a little bit more about working with Houdini, Houdini Engine, and Unity together?
One thing we love about Houdini is to be able to have it inside the game engine, right?
Yes.
And be able to tweak things and move things around. The level design process is quite simple to create these meshes. We were able to create a lot of levels, but at the end everything worked perfectly and I was able to solve all the things. I had to ask a lot of things inside the Discord, and it was very, very good to have this community and all these people willing to help.
Could you just tell us a little bit about some of the SideFX Labs tools that you used?
For game development, it's very useful. I really love all the unwrapping tools. There's one tool for extracting the silhouette of the meshes that comes with the tool. I think my building tool would be impossible to make without that. It's very important. I also use a lot of tools to bake textures, those are great. Yes, I like the maps maker, that's awesome. The loads subdivision tool to create these kind of patterns from like some sort of distorted grid pattern or something like that. Like that's used in the tool. First, I tried to make my own code to have that, and it was taking too long. Then I can use this, and it's perfect. It saves a lot of time. I use it for the internal walls of the rooms.
Thanks, you know, for participating in Houdini Game Jam, and congratulations on your win.
Thank you.